Hey everyone, let me show you my new cubic curve calculator. So this curve with a scale on it works like a calculator. Let's say I want to multiply two numbers together, like 2 times 30. Then what I do is I draw a line through those numbers, 2 and 30. If I draw a straight line, it will cross at a third point, which is marked with 60. So it does the multiplication for you. It can do any multiplication like that. It can do division, addition, subtraction, squares and square roots. There's a copy of this in the description for you to print out and play with, but we are going to find out how this works as a calculator. If you're familiar with polynomials, then the explanation for this is fairly straightforward. But if you're not familiar with polynomials, then this will be new to you. This is a cubic curve. The equation for this curve was actually y equals x cubed minus 3x. But let's pretend that this is just a general cubic curve, but with no x squared term. So it's going to look something like y equals x cubed plus px plus q. So that's just a general cubic curve with no x squared term. The whole reason this works is because it has no x squared term. Fun fact, a cubic curve like this is called a depressed cubic curve. So you've taken away its x squared term and it then just sits around the house sulking all day. So now that we've got this depressed cubic, y equals x cubed plus px plus q, it's a mathematical fact that we can factorize that into three terms where you've got x minus something. That something is called a root. So you've got root 1, root 2, and root 3. Now there are a couple of things to notice here. First of all, when x is equal to a root, this whole thing is equal to 0. And the other thing to notice is, if we expand the right-hand side, and then we compare it with the left-hand side, have a look at how many x squared terms we've got. On the left, we've got 0 x squared terms. On the right, we've got r1 plus r2 plus r3. That means the three roots add up to 0. And it's this fact that turns it into a calculator. So what I want to do is draw a straight line so it intersects with the curve at three points. Let's call those three points A, B, and C. So it intersects the curve at three points. And we want to know the values of A, B, and C. Now a straight line can be written as y equals mx plus d. So we want to know when that straight line intersects with the curve. In other words, we want to know when these two things are equal. Or we could subtract mx plus d from both sides and we get a new depressed cubic. And A, B, and C are the solutions to this new depressed cubic equal to 0. And that means A, B, and C are the roots of this new depressed cubic. And we know the three roots of a depressed cubic are equal to 0 when we add them together. That means A plus B plus C equals 0. And that is the basis of how our calculator will work. Now, if I'd marked my curve here with its x values, then this would have turned it into a calculator for addition. And I would have had A plus B equals minus C. With this straight line here, this point is something like minus 1.48. This point is minus 0.3. And this third point, C, would have been plus 1.78. So I can use it as a calculator for addition. If I marked it with a scale using absolute values of x, then everything would have remained positive. But I didn't do that this time. What I've done here is I've marked this curve with a different scale. I've marked it with 10 to the power x. What I've got this time then is I've got 10 to the power minus c equal to 10 to the power a plus b. And 10 to the power a plus b is 10 to the power a times 10 to the power b. So I've turned it into a calculator for multiplication. So you can do addition with this, multiplication with this. Division and subtraction is fairly easy to do as well using A, B and C. If I wanted to do a square or a square root, then all I would do is draw a tangent to a point. So a square would be a tangent here, and where it crosses, you would get the square of that value. Now, this is almost like a slide rule, but it only uses one scale. You can make these yourself, so you can design them. You can pick your own cubic equation. I used y equals x cubed minus 3x here, but you don't have to use that. You can try things out for yourself. See if you can make your own cubic curve calculator. I'd like to see what you can design. And, well, apart from that, if you have been, thanks for watching.